This slide is cardiac muscle. The cardiac muscle is found in the heart. The current magnification is 400x total magnification. Now, what we're looking for are going to be the distinguishing features that make up cardiac muscle. So if we zoom in a little bit, we're going to be able to notice that we have striations in the cells. Now, the striations, or these lines going back and forth, those are similarities to your skeletal muscle. We also have the nuclei here. Here's one. There's no one down here. Now, the nuclei in cardiac muscle is a lot of times uninucleate, but it can be binucleate sometimes. So we have striations, we have this uninucleate. We also have branching cells. At this point, you can see how this cell is breaking from one cell down here into two. So we have the branching cells in your cardiac muscle. You'll also notice that there are some darker lines going across the cells. There's one right here, there's one here, a couple right here, down here as well. These lines are called intercalated discs. Now, the intercalated discs are actually the endpoints or junctions of your cardiac muscle cells. So if you're looking at this point, for instance, you can see here's a intercalated disc and here's another one, one nucleus in between. Here is an intercalated disc and here's another one, one nucleus in between. So this is one cardiac muscle cell. Here's a second cardiac muscle cell. So we have these intercalated discs. So that means in cardiac muscle, we have striations, typically uninucleate, branching cells, and these intercalated discs. Now the functionality is involuntary. Last time I checked, you cannot control your heart. You can't say heart speed up, heart slow down. No. So your heart, your cardiac muscle, is involuntary.